Need tools? We've got you covered. Go to ChromebookParts.com or click on the link below to pick up this sleek, portable toolkit. Flip the unit over and remove 4 8mm screws and 6 6mm screws from the bottom cover and bottom cover panel. Using the spudger, gently pop the panel free. Use the metal spudger again to pop the battery plug cover free. Push back the locking clip and gently unplug the battery from the motherboard. Remove 4 5mm screws from inside the panel. Flip open the locking clip and unplug the daughterboard cables from the motherboard. Flip open the locking clip and unplug the touchpad cable from the motherboard. Flip open the locking clip and unplug the Palmrest cable from the motherboard. Peel back the tape and unplug the LCD cable from the motherboard. Peel off the foam covering and gently pull up to unplug the Wi-Fi antennas from the motherboard. Use a spudger to carefully unplug the last daughterboard cable from the motherboard. Flip the unit back over, open it up, gently insert the opener pick between the palm rest and the bottom cover and slide along the edges to pop the palm rest free. There are still cables connected underneath, so don't pull up too hard on the palm rest just yet. Peel back the tape and thread the touchpad cable through its slot. Remove 2 4mm screws from the hinge, 2 3mm screws from the motherboard, and 2 3mm screws from the heatsink. Gently lift up and pull back on the motherboard, taking care not to bend or damage the ports. You should now be able to unplug the speakers from the motherboard. Remove 3 3mm screws from the battery. Peel back the tape that's covering the speaker cables. lift the battery up, and unwind the speaker cables from their grooves. Replace the battery. And replace the three 3mm screws. Reseat the speaker cables back into the grooves on the battery. Replace the tape covering the speaker cable. Plug the speakers back into the motherboard. Put the motherboard back into place, taking care not to bend or damage the ports. Make sure to get all the cables out from underneath. Replace the two 4mm screws in the hinge, the two 3mm screws in the motherboard, and the two 3mm screws in the heatsink. Replace the palm rest and thread the touchpad cable back through its slot. It makes it easier if you put the tape down to hold it in place. With the palm rest slightly raised, thread the palm rest cable through its slot. Push down to snap the palm rest into place. Close the unit, flip it back over, replace the four 5mm screws into the motherboard. Plug the daughterboard cables back into the motherboard. This can take some time with the smaller daughterboard cable, so just be patient and try not to use too much force. Plug the touchpad cable back into the motherboard. Plug the palm rest cable back into the motherboard. plug the LCD cable back into the motherboard. Reseat the LCD cable back into its grooves. Gently push down on the Wi-Fi cables to plug them back into the motherboard. Replace the foam covering. Replace the foam covering. Plug the battery back into the motherboard and push the locking clip closed. Replace the battery plug panel and replace the bottom cover panel. Replace the four 8mm screws and six 6mm screws back into the bottom cover.